Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making strawberry syrup. I wanted to make a couple of strawberry things before it was really expensive to get strawberries. Right now we could still get them reasonably priced. I have made blueberry syrup at the beginning of summer, and a lot of people have asked me questions like, can I use raspberries, can I use blackberries, can I use strawberries? So I thought I would demonstrate doing the same recipe really, but using strawberries so that we have strawberry syrup. One thing I'm going to do different this time is I'm going to use stevia as the sweetener instead of sugar, because when you have a syrup and you put it on ice cream or something like that, it just adds more sugar, more calories, and here we can have a nice fruit, fresh fruit, strawberries. We're going to cook it actually, and it will provide our syrup, but we don't want to load it down with a lot of calories and a lot of sugary taste. So that's one thing that's going to be different. You need a small pot that you're going to take to the stove, and 1 cup of your fruit, and it can be any berry that you like. So we're doing strawberries this time. 1 cup of strawberries. And they're sticking to the bottom here, so I'm going to get all of them out. And I will add in 1/4 cup of water. You notice this little measuring cup? Some of you may have seen my shopping trip for kitchen gadgets, and I got a couple of these because I really like using the small size. That's 1/4 cup. After you put that in, stir it around, and then go to the stove. And what we're going to do is I'll pick that burner right there, turn it on, and bring this to a boil. Let it boil for 10 minutes, stirring occasionally. This is what your strawberries look like after you have boiled them for 10 minutes along with the water. So we're going to sieve this, and it will leave the pulp behind, although some of it will go through, making it nice and thick and desirable. But the rest will stay behind, so we'll have a very smooth and silky type of syrup. So just press on the strawberries. You see they've changed color a bit, they're a little pink. If you want to brighten up your syrup at the end, you could add a drop of red food coloring, but I don't find that necessary myself. But this is about what you're going to have. I'll just stop right there and scrape from the bottom to get any pulp that came through. And what I need to do is just hold on to this in my left hand. And in my right hand, I'm going to pour this back into the pot. And then I have a place to rest my sieve. And now you put your sweetener in. So it might be sugar for you. It's 1/4 cup. For me, it's stevia. So that goes in. It's measured cup for cup. So the amount that it says in the recipe of stevia would be the amount for sugar that you would use. And just stir that together. I need to use my wooden spoon. And the stevia doesn't want to blend in as easily, but this does go back to the stove and gets cooked for 5 to 8 minutes. So a little more cooking and then we'll be done. I let the strawberry syrup boil for about 6 minutes or so. And the next thing that I did, this was just my choice, was to put it into some cold water. Now this water is warm, because I wanted to serve it from a little pouring pitcher, and I didn't want to break the pitcher. So now this is still warm. I like it warm. You can serve it warm or cold, but if you're going to use an antique pitcher, then cool it down a little bit before you pour it in. And you'll notice it doesn't make a whole lot. So if you need a whole lot of syrup for what you're doing, then just double, triple, or quadruple the recipe as needed. Now what I'm going to do is come over to some scones, or a scone, that we made earlier, and you might have seen that video. It was on strawberry scones, so if you want to look it up, you can see what we did to make these. But I have my scone ready, and what I'm going to do is put a little bit of whipped topping on it. And I do have a quick tip for making whipped cream topping, if you need to refer to that. I'm just using this bottle kind that you can squirt out. And I'll just put that on top, and that gives a nice bed or cushion for the syrup, because we want to be able to see it, and I think just pouring it over the scone would not do it justice. So just let it drizzle down like that. And then I have a strawberry here, which I have cut vertically and then spread apart. So it's a strawberry fan. You might want to use that for decoration. Now I would wipe this up before serving it to somebody, but that's what it looks like. So I'll come back and take a bite in just a minute. Here's my strawberry syrup, and it's on top of some whipped topping, which is on top of a scone. Now I've already tasted the scone for you, so I don't want to go all down to that. I'm just going to skim off the top because I really want to analyze the strawberry syrup for you. Tastes really good. Now a lot of my taste came from that whipped topping. I'll go down here to the bottom and just scrape off some. So it's just strawberry syrup alone. It is a little tart, and that's because of the substitution of stevia in place of the sugar. But Rick and I have come to enjoy foods that are not as sweet as maybe we once preferred, and we consciously try to add less sugar. So we would just go ahead and leave it like this. But if you want more stevia or sugar or more sugar, just up to your taste. It's totally up to you. It's your recipe now. Enjoy.